You're watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. Follow along with projects and footage with a premium download available at BorisFX.com. We are coming up to the final part of exercise 5, the right way to use tracking data. And what we're going to be focusing on in this exercise is how we can take that same tracking data that we have created previously and do something completely different with it. In this case, we're going to be stabilizing up this shot. So we saw this shot in the first part, and we've got the same clip here. So we've got the same data that we had previously. And if we pop into Mocha, you can see we have exactly the same tracking data as previously. It's just a duplicated clip. Let's come into the tracking data, and I'm just going to make sure that we have the correct tracking data loaded in. This is always a good thing to check. So create tracking data, make sure our hilltop track has the cog against it, and hit OK. Now, to use this tracking data for stabilization, we have to do two things differently. The first thing is we come into our tracking data and click on the invert. And this will then automatically change all the data so it's going to be inverted into the right way. I'm going to make sure that I'm still in transform. I still want to do transform data to this. When it comes to which layer I'm exporting to, when stabilizing, we always apply it to the layer that we have tracked. So I'm going to come in, this is layer 5, and now I'll apply that export. Okay, so let's just do a quick RAM preview and see what we get here. And this is quite an interesting effect. You can see that around the area that we stabilized up, around the top of the hill, this is now, you know, completely stable. The rest of it is changing up, but this area is staying the same. So let's have a little look at what's happening. I'm going to come down to our layer number 5 here, and I'm just going to hit U to bring up all the keyframes. And I'm going to close down the Mocha Pro so that we only have the position, scale, and rotation keyframes. And it's at this point that I can decide what type of data that I want to maintain stabilization around. If I don't want to keep scale stabilized, so we want to maintain the drone moving forward, I'm going to come hit I just to come to the endpoint, and I'm going to turn off scale. So I'm going to come to my scale and just click on the stopwatch, and that will delete all the keyframes for scale. So now we're just going to be stabilizing around the rotation and the position. And if I don't want to stabilize the rotation at all, let's come back to our starting frame here. Turn off the rotation in the same way, just by clicking on the stopwatch. And now we're just going to be stabilizing out the position. So this keeps our top area of the hill nicely in the same place, in the same position all the time. And we can keep this stabilized in. We can even add keyframes into the anchor point if we want to. If I come to the front frame here, I can add a keyframe to the anchor point at the start. Come here and then just kind of add a keyframe into the anchor point at the end as well. And this will, this works just to take out the sort of big jitters that are in the shot, whilst keeping the general movement going forward. Already you can see we've got quite a lot of flexibility with just using the invert to do stabilization. I'm going to do one other thing here though. I'm going to come back into Mocha, and we're going to look about where it stabilizes around. And you'll notice that we started the most stable at the first frame. If I come to the end frame and align our surface to the edges here. So we've seen this previously. Zoom out almost, or move along with the drone there. So let's save this one out now. Exit out of here. We need to recreate the track data because we changed something with the surface. I'll hit OK on that. Everything else I can leave with the same values as previously. So we had invert turned on, transform, and exporting to the same layer. So hit apply the export there. We can see the scale is at 100. Actually, I need to reset my anchor point because I forgot. That's the only thing we haven't changed. Do a quick round preview on this. And now we can see we're pretty much stabilized around the top of the hill, which is where we did our tracking. But we can much more clearly see that perspective shift that's going on in the background. So this is a kind of an interesting little effect that we can get, almost like that sort of push zoom effect that you see in Goodfellas and Jaws. And here we go to the out point. You can see the scale is set to 100 and the position is set to its default and the rotation is set to 0. And if we go to the start, the zoom is now set. Oh, there we go. Let's go to the actual start. The zoom is now set to 152. So it's using the end point as its reference frame and then working out from that. And that's just by changing where the surface is within Mocha. So that's one way that we can use the transform stabilization, but we don't have to just do stabilization around transform. Let's take a look at our next clip. I've tracked the poster on top of this taxi. Create track data, taxi add track. There we go. I've got my invert turned on. And I'm going to show you what we can do with the corner pin stabilization here as well. As before, we're going to apply it to the clip that we tracked. Apply the export. Let's render that through. And you can see that poster now is absolutely rock solid. Why would this be useful? I'll show you why. I'm just going to duplicate up my clip. Okay, so I'm going to paint on this now. So if I double click, and this should load it up into the layer viewer here. If it doesn't load it up into the layer viewer, you might need to Alt or Option double click depending on how you have After Effects set up. And in my view, I'm going to come down to corner pin. So this gives us a view of all of the effects that we have in the render order, really. And I'm going to go into my paintbrush up the top, and I'm just going to do something that looks really, really good. But you're going to look at this and you're going to think, wow. I'm going to change Harry to Barry. And I'm going to cross out the name there. There we go. What I also want to do, obviously, is let's open this up. Is I want to make sure that my paint strokes are going across the entire range of the clip, and they're currently not. So I'm just going to stretch those paint strokes out. Okay, so if we have a little look at this here, we can see because I've stabilized around the poster, that looks, you know, absolutely fine now. There we go, looking pretty good. So I'm going to come in now and I'm going to reverse this stabilization. So how do we do that? Well, let's come into the composition and we're just going to spend a moment just to tidy this up so it's a bit clearer what we're looking at. I'm just going to solo out our copy and I'm going to call this one painted poster. And I'm going to make sure I'm painting on transparent. And now let's pre-compose this. So right click, pre-compose. I will move all my attributes into a new composition. I will adjust the composition duration to the time span. And I don't need to open that composition anymore. I'm happy with how that is. So that's just going to look like that. So it's time to reverse that stabilization. Now, if I just came in and turned off the invert, and apply the corner pin there, that's going to apply the corner pin still to the poster, which isn't quite what we want. So let's come into Mocha. And I'm going to show you another really important technique. And this is how we align a surface to the edges of the image. So I'm going to take my taxi add track and I'm going to duplicate it. And the only thing I'm going to do here to change it up is to click on this button at the top, which is our align surface button. Or I could come down to the surface and click on align surface here. So this is going to push out our surface to the corners of the frame. So when I play this back, it's still going to move based off of our track. So I've saved that, come out, and let's see what the result of that is going to be when we apply this to our stabilized pre-comp. So I'm going to make sure I've got the right tracking data. So create that new tracking data, corner pin. We're applying it to the right layer. Let's apply the export. Okay, nothing looks like it's changed, which is a good sign in this case. Let's do a round preview. And there we go. We've now got our paint strokes going across in exactly the right area. So this is a slightly more advanced technique than just doing regular stabilization. So this is a stabilize-destabilize workflow. When we're trying to, you know, touch up mistakes or, you know, paint out logos and things like that, this is a very, very powerful way of doing the stabilize-destabilize workflow using stabilize pre-comps. So we've been through a lot in a very short space of time in this one. I will say that the good thing about this sort of video training is that you can always go back and watch something again if you haven't quite understood it. So you can try it out for yourself. You have all the footage. And then when you get a bit stuck, come back, watch those bits again, and eventually you will understand it. Because some of the techniques we've shown here will take a little bit of time to sink in. Before we leave exercise 5, I just want to say one last thing, and this is a gotcha that happens to a lot of people when they're coming in and correcting tracking data. So you put your corner pin in, things aren't quite right. You go back into Mocha, you change up the surface so everything is perfect. You create more tracking data and you apply the export and things just start to go wrong. And they go wrong and they go more and more wrong. And you keep, you know, you look at these things, you go, oh, what have I done? What have I done? The more you hit apply export, the worse everything gets. The simple reason for that, if we come to our layer now, you can see every time we hit export, if we have corner pin selected, we're writing a new corner pin effect into here. So if you've got bad corner pin data, remember to remove it just by clicking on the effect and then deleting it, and it will get rid of it. If we have multiple corner pins, that's almost never a good sign. The other thing is trips people up quite a bit. If you've gone between corner pin that supports motion blur and a corner pin that doesn't support motion blur and things aren't looking right, you're probably going to have extra keyframes in your position, scale and rotation that you just want to get rid of and reset. And then everything will turn out fine for you again there. Yeah, I didn't want to leave exercise 5 without just sort of going over that last little gotcha. All right, let's leave the fundamentals now of Mocha, of how we generate up the shapes, how we find the areas we want to track and what type of tracking we want and how we use that data. And we're going to look in exercise 6 about how you adjust your track. So sometimes, no matter how hard you try, the footage just won't track in correctly. Maybe you've got too much motion blur. Maybe you've got too much occlusion, so something crossing your screen where you literally have nothing to track. In exercise 6, Mary's going to take you through the best ways to fix problems with your tracking data and also look at the adjust track module. So we'll see you again in exercise 6.
You've been watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. To download all videos, projects, and footage, purchase the premium version available at borisfx.com.